Thank you, Tanya, for joining me today. I'm so happy that I'm here with you. So I was hanging out at the apartment and I found a book sitting just on the living room. So I started reading the book and I told my manager, Esther, and she was like, oh, you know, that's Sosie's book. Maybe we can manage to get a conversation with her. And well, we're here. Thank you so much.
It's so amazing. And I'm so honored because it's such an important topic and the awareness that you bring to it really will make a difference.
It's something that we all live at some point of our lives, that it shouldn't be happening. It's not okay. But there's people here that can give advice and that can bring the help to them.
And it's very hard to share these stories because they're humiliating. The details are painful. But I wanted to shift the perception of what a victim looks like. You know, a lot of people were surprised when my story became public. And for those who might not know what exactly happened to me, I was in a relationship with the former Attorney General of New York State, whom it turned out had a pattern of abusing women. When my story became public, there were 4 women who had been identified. And now I know of at least 8 women. Yeah. And he had been the Attorney General for a very long time. But when I talk about the unexpected power of being a survivor, after I shared my story, more women reached out to me to say that they had been abused by him. And also he was replaced by the first woman, Attorney General of New York State, Letitia James, who then conducted the investigation of the former governor, Andrew Cuomo. And now New York State has 2 women at the top of the political ladder. I mean, that was like not intended, totally not expected, but I think it's a testament to what can happen when we share our truths.
Yes.
You never know what change might occur.
That's how you change the world.
There's also an unexpected power that we can tap into by sharing our stories.
Yes.
It was important for me to write a book that I hope would help others to spot and stop and prevent intimate partner violence, and also to show the reader that you can go from being a survivor to a thriver. I take the reader through my trajectory of being a child who watched domestic violence between my parents, and then very unexpectedly finding myself becoming a victim when I was an adult. And I had always thought that I would never become a victim. I had always thought I would run. But abusers are very skilled at breaking even the strongest women down.
Yeah.
And I wanted to show that even fierce women get abused.
Yes.
I also felt very fortunate that I could write the story, that I could share it, because most people suffer in silence.
Yes.
So I wanted to hopefully shine a light on this issue and also provide solutions.
Yeah, at the end of the book, you give all this resources of where women can get help.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought that was brilliant.
In the appendix, I also have how to spot intimate partner violence,
yes,
like the signs of abuse,
yes,
to recognize that it's not just physical, that it's emotional, verbal, digital, legal. There's
economical,
so many,
yeah.
Economic. There's so many forms of abuse.
Yes.
And until it happens to you, I think it can be very hard to recognize it.
Yes.
So I want to give people the tools to recognize it before it happens to them.
I love a part of your book. You said to a friend, the bad guy always wins. And then your friend said, storytellers also win. And I think that is a powerful message. And in that moment, my heart broke.
Oh.
I cried like 3 times while I was reading your book, I swear. It's a message to the world to realize that your story is powerful. And it's liberating for you, and it's liberating also for the ones that are listening to you.
Yes.
So Tanya, what's next? I would love to hear if you have any new projects coming.
What I want to do now, after having written Assume Nothing, is I want to write a companion book that will be for girls and young women.
Wow.
And right now I'm calling it Trust Yourself.
Okay.
Because there's so many steps that can be taken to prepare girls and young women to stand up for themselves, to support each other, to be able to recognize when they're being bullied and abused, and to speak out about it, and also self-defense training.
Yes, I love that.
So I'm very excited that Assume Nothing is being turned into a television series.
Oh my God!
It was a complete surprise, but an executive producer had read the book and optioned it, so I have to keep the details confidential. Yes. For now. I'm really eager to say it's an incredible team involved, an incredible star, but the details will be shared very soon. And I'm most excited because it means that the message of the book will reach a very different and large audience.
Yeah, oh, that's amazing. Congratulations.
Thank you. it's surreal. It's very surreal, but in a good way. Also, I produce films and I started a new job this year, the senior advisor for gender justice narratives at the Pop Culture Collaborative. So I'm working right now on building a cohort that will shift the narrative waters around gender justice, because despite all the strides that have been made by women, the reality is that in our popular culture, positive gender justice narratives are very few and far between, and in fact, harmful gender justice narratives are out there. I'm hopeful that we can shift the narrative water, so that's what I'm working on.
Oh my God, that is amazing. There's a part of your book, actually you mentioned it several times, where a lot of friends supported you into sharing your story, but there was also people that try to stop you from doing that. Mm-hmm. How difficult it was for you, because you knew what the right thing to do was. So I have to thank you for doing it, to having the courage for sharing your story.
For me, it was about following my heart and doing the right thing, but it was also about my conscience.
Yeah.
You know, I could not have it on my conscience that if I stayed silent, other women would be abused by him.
Yeah.
And I knew that they would be. So I'm grateful that you read the book, that you connected with it, and then that now we're able to connect is very exciting for me.
Yeah. Where can people get the book?
So I am at Tanya Author, T-A-N-Y-A Author, on all platforms, on social media, so they can find the book there. And then my website is tanyaturnsup.com, and there's a link to buy the book on the website. But the book is available wherever books are sold.